Thanks for being here this afternoon. Our Chief Trial Deputy Ryan Mears is going to summarize the nature of the charges that were filed this morning against Officer Lawson. But before we do, I just want to make a couple of quick observations. First of all, and this is again going to sound like a broken record, but just feel that we need to emphasize how potentially damaging it is to an investigation when information regarding that investigation gets out to the public prior to the completion of that investigation. You know, in this case, obviously, there was video done at Shortridge High School that was on social media. We have no control over that. However, then a private attorney saw fit when a second video became available, and it became known that there was a second video from across the street, saw fit to not only release that video to the press, but to put it together in a side-by-side. Again, I'll say again, as we've said over and over, in the course of an investigation, we need to be able to rely upon individuals who come forward that it's based upon their personal information and not based upon something that they had seen on television or read in the paper. Anyone who would have come forward after these videos were in the public domain, there is no way would be able to determine whether it was based upon firsthand knowledge or whether what they saw. And as a consequence, even if it was helpful information, their credibility would be undermined by that. And my second observation is this, and I will say that since the video is in fact already out in the public, and this observation by no way, in no means, do I mean to excuse the officer's behavior. Obviously, we're not excusing the officer's behavior because we have filed these charges this morning. But our hope would be that adults could act like adults. There is a woman in the video who, when she came to the school, identified herself as the young man's mother. In fact, she is the young man's aunt. And when she was asked to leave the property, rather than doing so or talking in a calm manner with the IPS officer who was asking her to leave, she screamed, she yelled, she dropped F-bombs, she dropped MFers, and not only could you hear it in the first video, the second video that surfaced was literally from across the street, and she was screaming at such a loud volume that it could be heard in the video from across the street. We simply would hope that adults could act like adults, and if it happened here, this whole circumstance would have been avoided. Again, in no way do we excuse the officer from what occurred next. Ryan will summarize.
Thank you, Prosecutor Curry. Once again, my name is Ryan Mears, and I'm the Chief Trial Deputy at the Marion County Prosecutor's Office. First of all, I'd like to thank IPS for making all of their personnel available to us so we can complete a thorough investigation. I'd also like to thank IMPD for their efforts and the lengths that they went to in order to complete the investigation in this matter. The materials that we reviewed in this particular case, we were in a position to review multiple videos which captured this incident from a variety of different perspectives. We also had multiple witnesses came forward with statements and witness testimony who were present on scene, who provided their accounts of what occurred. And we also reviewed the reports submitted by Officer Lawson after this incident occurred. Once we had the opportunity to review all of that information, all of that evidence, all of those facts, we made the determination that it was appropriate to file charges against Officer Lawson for his role in the incident that occurred at Shortridge High School. In particular, Officer Lawson is being charged with one count of battery as an A misdemeanor, one count of false informing, one count of official misconduct, one count of obstruction of justice, and one count of perjury. I'd like to first start with the battery. And the battery in question in this particular case, the threshold question for us was whether or not Officer Lawson was acting in self-defense. In other words, did he have a reasonable fear that justified his actions? We had the opportunity to review video, multiple angles of the incident. We also had the witnesses who were present when this incident occurred, And at the conclusion of considering all the evidence, we determined that it was appropriate to file a battery charge against Officer Lawson. In addition to the battery charges, we also filed a number of charges related to Officer Lawson's police report and probable cause affidavit that were submitted in this particular case. Officer Lawson drafted and submitted a police report, and the version of facts that were outlined in that report are not consistent with the video or the witness statements that we received. In fact, the video evidence as well as the witness statements directly contradict Officer Lawson's report. There are a number of not only inaccuracies but false statements that relate to material facts, which is why we decided it was appropriate to file those additional charges against Officer Lawson. We had the opportunity to review all of this evidence, and we are hopeful that this sends a strong message to the community that we take these allegations very seriously, that these matters will be thoroughly investigated, and that it does not matter to the Marion County Prosecutor's Office who is the defendant or who is the victim. We are going to evaluate these cases based on the merits of what occurred and what is appropriate to charge based on those facts, and that's what we did in this particular case. Turn it over to Prosecutor Curry.
Any questions?
Yes, he turned himself in.
Arrangements be made for him to surrender to the court. Yes.
He has already.
I believe it's happening right about now. I believe.
Without this video or the videos, would you have been able to make these charges?
Well, certainly, in terms of the strike that occurred, probably not. The report was that. He did so with an open palm strike, and no, without the video. But you know, if that's provided to us, then obviously in this instance, as we have it, we can make a determination that we believe that that was not the case.
And you mentioned you're sending a strong message to the community. What message are you sending to police?
Well, I think hopefully the message is that everyone's going to be treated fairly, and that we're going to assess everyone based on their conduct. And we'll evaluate their conduct under the law as it applies to whatever they may or may not have done, and then try to make a fair determination as to how we should proceed.
What's happening to the other officers
over there? The other officers...
Are they being charged, or...?
No, the only individual who's being charged as a result of this incident is Officer Lawson.
Is there anything in his personnel?
Number one, I don't know, and number two, we couldn't speak to it even if we did. That's an administrative matter with IMPD. Okay. All right. Thanks.
This is a status with the police department.
Has IMPD released their statement?
Yeah, they're going to issue a statement.